So my name is Dr. Linus Keating. I have a doctorate in geology, and I'm a principal of Walnut Mines, a partnership that owns the underlying property here at Hot Breccia. I've seen and worked in porphyries all over the world for a number of major players, and Hot Breccia is a place that has bothered me for many years. We first looked at it back in the mid-90s. One of my partners brought it to my attention, and I subsequently took a look at it and was intrigued. And many years fell in between that and our acquisition of the claims here in 2019 or something like that. Knowing Arizona the way I do, and I went to the University of Arizona, so I have a good handle on Arizona porphyries and mineralization. This area, Hot Breccia, is right in the heart of some of the most productive territory. Just to the northwest over here is the Christmas mine. It was mined since 1900, and it currently has 300 million tons of copper reserves. In the far distance is the smelter of the Asarco-Hayden complex and the Ray mine, one of the largest porphyry coppers in the world. To the south of us is Salmon Well in Kalamazoo, which was an enormous BHP operation. So we're in the heart of what goes on. To our advantage, the Hot Breccia property is named because we have breccias. These are actual hydrothermal breccia pipes. They're vertical features that have come up from below as a result of high pressures when the magma intruded the area. And these are explosive events. They're events that you wouldn't want to be standing around when this happens. It would be a very dangerous situation. But they're full of gas, they're full of volatiles, and as a result, they tend to drag and break material and bring it upwards. And the great thing about Hot Breccia is that we have a number of these breccia pipes scattered around, and many of them have beautiful, large, rounded chunks of skarn. Skarn is a rock that was originally limestone, but the chemistry of the intrusive and the alteration that's gone on has totally replaced the limestone in the rock and left behind iron and garnets and a number of higher temperature minerals, and also copper and gold. And so we have the advantage at Hot Breccia of being able to see these breccia pipes that have come up from significant depths. And they show us on the surface that deep down we have these bodies of skarn. Skarn develops around the edges of an intrusive in the limestones, and skarn is a major producer of high-grade copper in southern Arizona. Skarn is responsible for the high grades at South 32's Hermosa property. It's responsible for the high grades at the Christmas mine, just a couple miles northwest of us. And we have these same rocks, these same host rocks, here underneath Hot Breccia, underneath this pile of Cretaceous volcanics. Another advantage we have at Hot Breccia is that back in the mid-70s, Kennecott, in a joint venture with Conoco Minerals, drilled some deep holes out here. Based on a thesis that was written by Larry Barrett, Kennecott came out, they looked at the breccia pipes, and they agreed that this looked like a promising place. And so they took a chance. They drilled some deep holes, 3,000, 4,000 foot holes, and they actually intercepted long intervals of skarn rock with some high-grade copper. When a porphyry intrudes a sedimentary sequence like limestones, the heat, the pressure, the volatiles, the gases related to that magma affect the rocks around it. And in this case, it affected limestones. The limestones are very chemically reactive. They're a rock that's very susceptible. You know, even in an at home, you can drop a little bit of vinegar on a limestone and it'll start to bubble because it's breaking down and it's releasing CO2. So limestones are one of the very best, what we call hosts, for skarn mineralization. It's a product of the intrusive coming up and affecting the rocks into which it intruded. And sometimes this can combine to really produce some very high-grade copper values. And resolution has the same stratigraphic, that is limestone and sedimentary sequence, that we do here. And a lot of their high-grade ore is also skarn. So skarn is important. The geophysical work that Prismo has just completed indicates that there is a significant, possibly sulfide-rich body at depth that could represent the progenitor intrusive. And that in itself could be a large tonnage, fairly high-grade opportunity.
Linus, when you talk about high-grade mineralization, what's high-grade for you?
So what we see in the skarn fragments that are coming up along the breccia pipes are values in the order of 3 to 5% copper. And that 5% copper translates to $100 a ton, which is, 100 pounds a ton, which is $400 a ton rock. That's rock that you could mine just about anywhere.